Yeah, I don't even like the name Saudi Arabia, because our Prophet, Allah's blessings be upon him, gave it a name. And if the Prophet used a name, then that is the Sunnah. He called it Jaziratul Arab. And in Jaziratul Arab, meaning the Arabian Peninsula, Jaziratul Arab, in Jaziratul Arab, there were regions. One region in which Mecca and Medina were located was called Hijaz. Another region next door to the Hijaz was called Najd. And then there was, to the south, there was Yemen and Hadramaut and so on. This is the Arabian Peninsula. And along came Abdulaziz ibn Saud in 1924, took over Mecca by force, and then proclaimed himself king of the Hijaz. King of the Hijaz. And Sultan of Najd. And in 1926, he convened a conference in Mecca, an international Islamic conference, to establish his rule over Mecca and Arabia on firm foundation to get the acceptance of the world of Islam. I have a book on the subject. It's entitled The Caliphate, the Hijaz, and the Saudi Wahhabi Nation State. And in that book, I have recorded the text, the main points of the text that the king made, Abdulaziz ibn Saud, in that conference. And he declared that this country must have a neutral status, like Switzerland is neutral. It must not take sides with anyone. He said that this country must not wage war on anyone. And no one must wage war on this country. Those were his words. The king, the father of the present king, Salman. And today, Saudi Arabia, they gave it a new name after their own family, Saudi. Saudi Arabia. It's difficult for me on my tongue to even pronounce the word Saudi Arabia. Is waging war on innocent Yemen. And now is on the verge of provoking war with Iran. And if, of course, they're doing it on behalf of the United States of America. Everybody knows that. If they succeed in provoking war with Iran, this is going to involve war with Lebanon as well, war with Iraq as well. Egypt will be in it. Qatar will be in it. Turkey will be in it, and then eventually, of course, the United States will get what the United States wants, the war with Russia as well. United States is lusting for war with Russia, lusting. And President Donald Trump is just a pawn being pushed here and there. The master plan is war with Russia and war with China in order to rule the world. And so now the pawns are in place. And you have a young little upstart schoolboy who is the crown prince of Saudi Arabia now, Mohammed bin Salman. I call him a schoolboy. I don't know how long will it take, another 1 week, 2 weeks, 1 month, before Saudi Arabia, using some pretext or the other, will provoke war with Iran. When that happens, there is an expression in English, they say, all hell break loose. The world is going to be changed. It's not going to be the same world anymore. They're going to end up getting the Armageddon that they're lusting for, the Malhama. I recall 1976, July 1976, yes, I recall it. Because King Faisal, the brother of King Salman, King Faisal of Saudi Arabia, had stood up against the Zionists after the war of 1967. when Jerusalem was captured. And King Faisal had imposed an oil boycott on the United States when the war of 1973 took place, the Arab-Israeli War of 73. And when the price of oil went up by 400% and the money was coming in, then Pakistan had an intelligent ruler at that time. I don't know, Pakistan always has a schoolboy, but they had an intelligent ruler at that time, Zulfikar Ali Bhutto. And Bhutto had the political acumen to realize that an opportunity had come. And he reached out to Faisal, and they quickly formed an alliance, a Bhutto-Faisal alliance. Maybe some of you are too young to know about this. And that alliance succeeded in bringing about the Lahore Islamic Summit Conference in February 1974, in which the world of Islam was coming together now to try to harness the resources which were coming through the price of oil to try to better the lot of the Muslims and to restore Islam as a stronger actor on the stage of the world. That's what the Lahore Islamic Summit Conference of 1974 was all about. And then the Western world, the Zionist world, was so alarmed by what Bhutto and Faisal had done. So alarmed, Kissinger threatened them. We said, we're going to make a horrible example of you. And 2 months later, they responded with India. India detonated their first nuclear device. Indira Gandhi was saying, this is how we're going to respond. And then Bhutto responded by saying, even if we have to eat grass, we will have a nuclear deterrent. We're not going to be blackmailed. Sorry to use that term. It should not be blackmailed. It should be white-mailed or blue-mailed or something. But why the black color? Anyhow, I'm sorry for that. When that alliance between Faisal and Bhutto took place, and they decided we're going to make a horrible example of them, it took them only 2 years, and they used a Saudi prince. Yes, they brainwashed a Saudi prince to go back to Saudi Arabia and to assassinate King Faisal. And then they got Bhutto overthrown and eventually hanged and made a horrible example of him. And now once again, it's a Saudi prince. Yes, I'm sure he must have gotten all the brainwashing in the United States, yeah? And they're using another Saudi prince today to do their dirty work for them. So this history repeating itself, that they're acting through proxies. And I used today's program to warn that the war is coming. I thought it may have come from Korea. It may have come from Ukraine. But no, it's coming from Mohammed bin Salman, who is going to use whatever pretext he can to provoke war with Iran. So this is a warning of what is coming.